Let's get in, Sumit. Rima, after DM Healthcare, Aster DM Healthcare is looking to raise about 980 crores from the primary market. The IPO opens for subscription today, and Sumit is here to fill us in with the details. Sumit.
So this is the fifth IPO of 2018 and so far the largest one. The company is looking to raise 980 crore rupees at a price band of 180 to 190. And at the upper end of the price band, that is 190, the company is valued at close to 9,600 crore rupees. Now the IPO is a combination of fresh issue and an offer for sale. And in the offer for sale, the promoter is selling shares worth 255 crore rupees. And it is raising 725 crore rupees as a fresh issue, which it will use for debt repayment and to purchase medical equipments. Now if you see, Aster DM is one of the largest healthcare service provider in three regions, that is Middle East, India and Philippines. Now Middle East can also be called as the Arab Nations or the GCC. Now it operates, now it gets majority of its revenue from the GCC states, that is the Middle East states, but over the period it has increased its revenue from India. Now in FY15 it used to get around 11% of its revenue from India, and in, as of first half of financial year 2018 it increased to close to 18.5%. Now it operates in three different segments, that is hospitals, clinics and pharmacies. Now hospital contributes around 49% to its revenue, while clinics and pharmacy contribute around 26% and 25% to its total revenue. Now if you see, it operates around 323 operating facilities in 9 different countries, of which it has around 9 hospitals with a total bed size of around 4,754. Now going forward, the company is looking to expand and add 10 more hospitals, which will also add approximately 1,727 beds to its total beds. Now Aster DM has a bunch of listed peers, but Apollo Hospitals and Fortis are the nearby players given the size of the company. Now Aster DM's revenue and net profit grew at a compounded annual growth rate of 32.5% and 21.3% over FY13 to FY17. But if you see the growth rate, if you see the financials of the of Aster DM, they are not they are a bit inconsistent, because in the financial year 2016 the company reported a loss, and in financial year 2017 the company could report a net profit because of an exceptional gain of close to 596 crore rupees. As of first half of financial year 2018, the company has again reported a loss. On the return ratio side, if you see, the company's return ratios are not that impressive. The return on equity for the financial year 2017 stood at 10.6%, while for while the ROCE, that is return on capital employed, was close to 0.2%, and return on asset was 2.9%. Now if you check the valuations of the company, on the hospital side, if you see the occupancy rate, it is the lowest among its peers, that is Apollo Hospitals and Fortis. It stood at around 60%, while its average revenue per occupied bed per day was close to 1,52,000 rupees. Lastly, on the valuations, if you check on the price to earnings, the shares are a bit expensive when you compare with Fortis, but not that expensive when you compare with Apollo Hospitals. On market cap to sales, it is cheaper when compared to Apollo Hospitals and Fortis, but on EV to EBITDA and on price to book, which are important metrics when it comes to hospital business, the shares are offered at an expensive valuation as compared to Apollo Hospitals and Fortis Healthcare.